The number one basketball player in this year's class has made his decision. Chet Holmgren is going to Gonzaga. The seven-footer from the Twin Cities chose the Zags over his hometown, Golden Gophers, where his father played, along with others like North Carolina and Ohio State. This was not a surprise. This is where our guys at 24/7 Sports had Holmgren going, committing to a team that is the early favorite to win the NCAA championship next season. Holmgren, we know where he's going now, but we still don't know where Jaden Hardy is going, the number two overall prospect in this year's class. This isn't 2022. This is this year's class. Hardy likely going the pro route. Patrick Baldwin Jr., who comes in number four, might be headed to a mid-major school in Wisconsin-Milwaukee. We're going to get more on all those guys in just a second. Let's bring in 24/7 Sports National Basketball Director Eric Bossi. Eric, what makes Holmgren what you call one of the most unique prospects in the last decade in college basketball?
Yeah, so we have all these guys. We like to call them big guys with skill unicorns, and it's maybe getting a little bit overused, but Chet really is. There haven't been many seven-footers like him who not only handle and shoot and pass like a guard, but he really moves like a much smaller player around the perimeter. And then you combine that with him being as good a shot blocker as we've seen in the last 10 or 15 years, an elite rebounder, and then a competitive makeup to get out there and dominate against anyone, not be afraid of anyone. He's just a unique guy that you don't see very often.
A lot of years, the number one player in that class is the best player in college basketball. We saw it with Zion Williamson. Is this player, I know he still needs to put on some weight, as you mentioned, is he ready to be a top five player in college basketball right away?
Yeah, I don't see why not. As I mentioned, he's got his competitiveness, but he's going to really a perfect fit in Gonzaga. They play through their big men. They play a skill-based game. They space the floor. He's going into a setup that's going to be built for him to succeed, and he's going to have some veteran talent around him, along with other incoming talent like fellow five-star Hunter Salas, who committed to Gonzaga about a month ago. So everything is put in place for him to be successful right off the bat.
You see the top 10, everybody's accounted for except for number two and number four. The number two ranked player, Jaden Hardy. The number four ranked player, Patrick Baldwin Jr. Can you give us a quick update where they're at in their decision process right now?
Yeah, you know, Jaden Hardy didn't have a senior year because they canceled things out in Nevada this year. So it's really been kind of quiet for him. But the expectation for quite some time now has been that he's going to go some sort of a professional route, whether that be the G League or maybe overseas somewhere. We'll see. But unless name, image, and likeness comes into play real quick, more than likely we'll see Hardy going the pro route. Now, with Pat Baldwin Jr., his father is the head coach of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, so there's a big draw to go play for his dad, you know, when the guy recruiting you is literally down the hallway from you. It's tough to say no, but I don't think Duke is totally out of that one just yet, but it would be a surprise to see him pick either of those schools, or a school other than either of those two.
All right, let's take a look at the team rankings for 2021 with still two of those top five players undecided. Michigan coming in at number one with a couple of five stars. Tennessee has a couple of five stars. Gonzaga just moved up from 7 to 3 thanks to the commitment from Chet Holmgren, the number one player in this class of 21. When you look at the top seven here, what stands out to you the most, Eric?
You know, I think you got to go with Juwan Howard right off the top, because when he took the job at Michigan, people wondered, hey, can a guy who has no college coaching experience come in and be relevant to these guys and sell what he's doing? And he's done it. You know, he's got a couple five stars. He's got a great in-state prospect in Kobe Bufkin. He's connecting with these guys. He's been around on the grassroots circuit with all these kids and his parents, as his own children have gone through it. So you combine that with his NBA experience, what he's showing he can do as a coach at Michigan, and they're the hottest thing going. And then, you know, Tennessee, they've got arguably the best point guard in the country coming in Kennedy Chandler. And then they received a huge boost last week when they got another in-state kid, Brandon Huntley Hatfield, to commit, a 6'9 power forward. And not only did he commit as a five-star, but he's going to come in a year early in 2021. So, you know, they don't need to go too far outside of the top two to really find some surprises.
I think last year when we had two of the top three or two of the top four guys decide to go to the G League, we thought maybe the floodgates were going to open and it was going to be multiple players year in and year out from the top five, top 10 that go. This year, so far, we may only get one. Right now, zero from the top 10, but we may get one. How might name, image, likeness change things moving forward?
You know, they could change things a lot because I think if people are looking, let's talk about Chet and Gonzaga, you know, because the G League's been talked about for him forever. And he said, no. He's got a great example. Look at how much a year at Gonzaga boosted Jalen Suggs in terms of just name brand and how well people around the country know him. If you've got name, image, and likeness on top of that, there's going to be a chance for kids to make some pretty decent money in college, but also to just increase their value as endorsers and as brands once they get out of college. You know, Jonathan Kuminga and Jalen Green, Isaiah Todd are doing great things in the G League program, but it's out of the public view. They're not really helping out their marketing brand and what they can come and earn as endorsers right out of the gate. So there's a lot to be had in college, and I think people learned that lesson first with Zion Williamson, and now they're learning it with some of these other guys. So it's going to be interesting to follow down the road.
Yeah, that's great news for college basketball fans like us. Appreciate it. Eric Bossi, 24/7 Sports National Basketball Director. On Chet Holmgren Day, decides he's going to Gonzaga. They are the favorites to win next year's national championship. It is early, though. Still don't know what some of those Zag players are going to do, like Drew Timmy. Is he coming back? If he is, this will likely hold firm. But Michigan, the number one recruiting class in the country. Baylor, the defending champs. And Villanova is getting healthy once more. Colin Gillespie coming back.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.